I'm Natalie and welcome to the Odds Box. Now, Dominic is otherwise engaged, but I have got some corkers lined up this week. I'm not an expert, but I'm guessing the first rule of train spotting is make sure you don't get hit by a train. Strictly speaking, this enthusiast did follow that rule, just narrowly avoiding the oncoming express that crept up through the steam at 70 miles an hour. Let's see it again. He barely flinched. Now, what are these people up to?
We're at the top of the world.
They are skydiving from the highest point possible in the world, Mount Everest. It's a 30,000 feet drop, but worth it for that view. Meet Copper the Fox and Jack the Lurcher. They've become best buddies after Copper was rescued by a wildlife centre in Cornwall. Just not quite sure how this is going to turn out when they grow up.
Occasionally it does get a little bit too harsh and Copper will squeak and Jack will let him go, or sometimes Jack will yelp, you know, where you can understand these little needle-like teeth in play.
For a potential new sport of cake diving, I would have expected a larger crowd. The name is misleading, though. Less of a dive, more of a prod around with one hand. These brides-to-be in Arizona were trying to find a diamond ring. Here is your winner. And did anybody have a sneaky taste of that cake? Yeah, I think somebody did. To possibly the world's youngest thieves on a mission to get some sweets. Check out this CCTV from Minnesota. The 3-year-old girl and 1-year-old boy make it into the Food Planet store despite a minor encounter with the door that somehow wandered off from their parents.
Who's your mum? Who's your daddy? Was it daddy? Was it mum? They don't answer me. They don't know.
The cops were called. Luckily, everything turned out fine. Halfway through, and it seems a good time to relax and admire the handiwork of an entire knitted underwater scene, complete with mermaids and freaky diver, in Appledore in Devon.
It's not something, as we said, grannies do, and it can be fun and exciting.
That's it. Now, spot the odd one out. Yeah, there she is. It's 94-year-old Hazel Suarez, who lives in California and has just completed a degree in art history. She gives a good excuse for why now.
After I raised 2 sets of children, I have 6 of them, then I realized that eventually, if I kept trying a few courses at a time, I might make it.
2 marriages, 6 children, and 40 grand and great-grandchildren later, Hazel finally managed to find some time for herself. Okay, here's a good story for the kids on how the parents met. Mummy worked in a robot factory. Daddy wanted to buy a robot, so they ended up having the robot preside over their wedding vows. Meet the Eye Fairy, this year's must-have wedding accessory. You can hold hands with it and everything. Ever seen a sheep in a body scanner? Me neither. But now you have. There is a serious side to these slightly disturbing pictures, though. It's to breed leaner sheep. It still looks weird. To our number one, and on the Odd Box, we love it when things go wrong on live TV. John Brown from KTVI in St. Louis was explaining how wild birds can be tagged to track them when this happens. He's not going to let go.
Okay, he's got to go. Albert has to go right now. Albert!
And screaming Albert. The bird's random name is really going to help.
Go, 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 fire!
Yeah, and just look at the bite damage.
Albert's a tough guy.
That is it for now. I'm Natalie Jameson. I'm on the Fern Cotton Show every weekday at midday on Radio 1. And there's more stuff like this online. Just go to bbc.co.uk/oddnews.